The song was Point of No Return. The year was 1977. I'm Richard Williams of Kansas, and these are the sounds of the time.
It all began the summer before 11th grade, when Williams got a guitar and invested in some lessons.
So my junior year, I started a band, my first band. We were called The Pets, and that was with Phil Ehart, who is my partner today. We've been playing together since junior year in high school, which was in 1966.
Williams says not long after, he found his true calling, after hearing music coming from a block party near his home.
I could hear a song called Land of a Thousand Dances, and this soul band was playing it out on the patio. What I heard rolling through the window, that sound was the entire lifestyle of being in a band. Not fame, not fortune, not, you know, studio work, not any of those things. The ups and downs, the travel, the good times, the bad times, the camaraderie of it. I really wanted to be part of whatever that was, to join the circus and see the world through those eyes. Then the Beatles on Ed Sullivan happened, and most musicians my age, my peers, that was probably what did it for them too. And Topeka, Kansas, like any other town, was lit on fire by that British invasion. There was a garage band on every block. Everybody I knew was in a band. Most of the same songs were played, so it was pretty easy to float in and out of different groups, so did that for a while.
As a lead guitarist who lost his eye in a fireworks accident, he and his bandmates played cover material, always making it their own.
We didn't want to just be in a band and just be write our own material, but we were really drawn to more progressive types of things that were coming out of England and Europe that showed us you don't have to work within the box of this is what rock and roll is. It can be whatever you want it to be. And I think that was what really forged us initially, was to be different, not just to be original, but to be uniquely Kansas.
There'd be earlier versions of Kansas with different members, but the goal was to sound different than everyone else.
What we were really learning in redoing other people's material was we were learning to be ourselves, approaching things as an orchestra in arranging, rather than a straightforward rock band approach. Taking like a violin, guitar, and a synthesizer, playing intertwining melodies or, you know, three-part harmonies together. And so doing all of these things, it kind of what creates what Kansas is.
They'd get a record deal, releasing their first album in 1974, putting out over a dozen more for the next 40 years. By the mid-70s, they'd strike gold, or platinum, that is, with their fourth album, Left Overture, and its hit single, Carry On, Wayward Son.
Carry on, my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done.
Their next album, Point of No Return, featured the top 10 hit, Dust in the Wind, and the album's opener, Point of No Return.
It's just telling a historical, fictitious tale of the sea. Very good use of the interplay with the violin in that song. So it's a very up sound. It's in the key of F. There's something about the songs in F that just sound different. The middle section, again, it's orchestrated. It's, you know, in the way that we did things. We always felt very important to, I know some people are more like, you know, don't bore us, get to the chorus. We're the opposite in that sense. We like to paint a tapestry and lead you somewhere. And not everybody cares for that, but we're not for everybody. But if we please ourselves, at least we're being true to ourselves, and there's enough people that seem to be following along.
William says he always felt like that song described Kansas.
We've always had a lot of nautical connotations to us, which doesn't make a lot of sense since we're as far from the ocean in Kansas as you can be. But there's something about being on a boat together, It sparks the imagination, and that really was what we were. And so to think of us as pirates out on the open sea, as silly as that sounds, it was kind of true.
And even after going at it for more than four decades, William says playing Kansas music is still his passion.
What I enjoy the most is being on the road and playing. That's the best part, is being out here, being with the guys. I love the life of it. You know, I love the guys. I love the crew. I mean, this is the adventure of my life. And it goes so far beyond money or fame. I am so grateful and so blessed that I get to be me. We've been around for 45 years. We're like a living, breathing Mount Rushmore, you know, and you better come see it before they tear it down. I do not stand on a soapbox and pump myself up. We are part of American musical culture.
He says when the day finally comes to put his guitar to rest, it'll be with a feeling of contentment.
When I'm done, I will have left everything I've got on the field. And when I walk away, I will never look back with regret. And I can even chisel that in stone. When I don't do it anymore, it's because I can't. And I can live with that. And if the band continued on, I could go there and watch them with pride and be happy for them and happy for me and happy for the legacy, the continuing legacy. But I wouldn't ever look at it with any regret. This is me. This is what I do. This is my chosen life, profession, my pride and joy.